You might be smarter. Your family might come from privilege. Your daddy might own a company, but you will not outwork me. How they paint the picture. I wasn't there, but the story said my man kind of sat down with the little jewel in his hand, and he was just thinking like, wow, I could buy a house, I could do this, I won't have to be homeless, I can get food. Like, he was just going down the line of all the things he could do with this particular jewel. And he was like, as soon as I get back, I'm cashing it in. He didn't think about the lady. He's like, I'm gonna cash this thing in, I'm gonna be rich, I'm gonna be set for the rest of my life. Woo! He pumped. But the story says, some kind of way, my man stopped and he started traveling back to the lady. And when he got back to the lady, he was like, you know what, ma'am? I've been really thinking, and this jewel is like phenomenal, but I want to give it back to you. And she tripping like, what? You want to give it back? He was like, yeah, I want to give it back to you, but I want something for you, from you in exchange for it. She was like, bro, this is worth millions. Like, I don't have nothing that's as valuable as this is. He said, nope, I'm giving it back. But when I give it back, you gotta promise me when I give it back, you give me something. So she's like, all right, cool. She took the jewel and she said, what do you want from me? And he said, what I want from you is whatever was inside of you that allowed you to get this to me. I'm gonna take my time because I wanna make sure you caught that. She said, he said, I don't want what you gave me. I want whatever's in you that allowed you
to be willing
to get
it.
You know, there's a whole lot of NBA players, but you ever notice when you watch the game, there's just some guys, they just on a whole different type of level, right? And when I study, so I'm gonna give you three things, I'm letting you go. I'm gonna give you three things that's within these people that make them do what they do. And one of the things, if you've ever watched Michael Jordan, if you've ever watched Kobe, and I'm not the greatest memory of Michael Jordan, all right? I want two people to take a guess. What do you think my greatest moment of Michael Jordan is?
What I love most about Michael Jordan was the last time he lost to the Pistons, he cried.
And when he walked off the court with the tears in his eyes, you know that one when you lose and you ain't even got no sportsmanship? You know that one? Normally, you know, you lose, you just man up. You don't want to shake their hand, but you do it anyway, because that's a part of the game. But when you get so tired of losing, when you get pissed, when you can't take losing no more, you lose the whole love, shaking a hand, and you just walk off. And Mike walked off with a tear in his eye. And let me tell you something. He walked off and said to himself, this will be the last time the Pistons ever beat me again. Dwight Howard, no respect for you. Listen to me. Even when you lose, okay to lose, but you can't ever get comfortable with it. You can never be satisfied with losing. When you lose, it's got to hurt. It's got to hurt.
They gonna love me for my ambition. Easy to dream a dream, but what's harder to live it? Look, they gonna love me for my ambition. Beautiful music, painting pictures, this be my vision.
Listen to me, pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year. But eventually, it will subside. And something else will take its place. If I quit, however, it will last forever. Y'all spoiled, some of y'all spoiled, just bottom line. Your parents have done everything for you. You never had to do nothing for yourself. You're spoiled. We're gonna keep it real tonight. Some of you are spoiled brats. Every time you ever got in trouble, somebody in your house got you out of it. Every time you've done something you're not supposed to do, people say, Eric, your mother's a tyrant. You're right. She kicked me out. You're right. She's mean, but she developed a man because she put me out there and said, you're gonna have to grow up. And some of you have never learned to grow up. And so every time something get hard, you quit, you call mama. I dare you to take a little pain. I dare you. I dare you not to go home. Somebody said, I don't go home, I feel bad. But go through it. You ain't gonna die. At the end of pain is success. You're not gonna die because you're feeling a little pain. I'm not eating like I eat at home. That's why you're about to go to the next level, because if you keep eating like you ate at home, you'll keep being a boy or a girl. It's time to become man, woman. But I'm exactly where I wanted to be, because I realized I gotta commit my very being to this thing. I gotta breathe it, I gotta eat it, I gotta sleep it. And until you get there, you'll never be successful in life. But once you get there, I guarantee you, the world is yours. So work hard and you can have whatever it is you want.
I would be an example. So when I came back with a vengeance. I was driven by a purpose. I'm telling you, you'll never be what you're supposed to be. You'll never have what you're supposed to have. You'll never ball out until you got a purpose for why you do what you do.
The people who blew up, they blew up because there was something that was going wrong in their life, and they took that pain and they turned that pain into something. You will never ever go to class, and you guys are spoiled. Do you know what it's like to go to class in Michigan in December? It's 10 inches of snow and they don't close the school.
and it's minus 10 degrees and you still got to go up and go to class? How do you go to class when it's 10 degrees and 12 inches of snow? You know how you do it? Because you know your mama broke and she working two jobs and taking out a loan for you to go to school. I laugh at kids whose parents are broke and they up there partying like everybody else. Your mama broke. You went to school. Listen to me. Some kids, when they go to school, they just going to school to keep the legacy alive. They mama already got money. Some of us, we taking out loans to help our... We taking our loans and sending it home so people can pay rent. That money ain't even going to college, and we still going to party.
So you hear me say on my video, I'm talking about opportunity. Listen to me. Sleep is the new broke, because what happens is, if you only have 24 hours... All right, I got to say this. I got to take my time, because I want to make sure you get this. If you only have 24 hours in a day, your success is dependent upon how you use the 24. You gotta hear me. People talk about Oprah Winfrey, you know, Ted Turner, Warren Buffett. Listen to me. I don't care how much money you make. You only get 24 hours in a day. In college, you're not in college. You only get 24 hours. And I blew up literally. I went from being a high school dropout to selling 6,000 books in less than 6 months. What happened? In my 24 hours. I was like, okay, Eric, you got to get a grip on your 24 hours because you're about to be broke for the rest of your life. And that's all I need you to do for me. I can tell you all about your life if you just write down your 24-hour schedule for me. You let me look at it. I can tell you where you're going to be in 5 years. I can tell you where you're going to be in 10 years. I can tell you where you're going to be in 20 years. Then he ended with a descriptive. He told me how he was gonna hustle, and he said, hustle what? Hard. But listen to me, if you really listen to the lyrics, if you really listen to the lyrics, and you apply the lyrics to your life, y'all would all be 4.35, 3.0 students. But you listening to the music, but you not letting them, listen to me, you're letting it hit your ear, but it's not hitting your soul. It's not hitting your heart, because I listen to it too. That's my song. That song gets me up at 3:30 every morning. I'm listening to it because he said he's going to. I don't know if you're listening to it or not, but I got you the first time when you said he was going to hustle, but that wasn't enough. He told me again, hustle, right? He like, look, I'm serious about it. Hustle, right? His whole language, everything about his body language. When you listen to this kid, Ace Hood, he sound hood when you listening to him. Like his name matched the words that are coming out of his mouth. He said, hustle, hustle, hustle hard. And I guarantee many of you would be 4.0 students if you studied hard. But you ain't studying hard. You could have had a degree. I'm grown. I don't need nobody 4.0. Somebody said, E, what you get in stats class? It don't make a difference what I got in stats class.
And then if you ain't got nobody, that, I'm grown.
Somebody else put, they got 2-3 languages. Who you think they gonna hire? You better learn you another language, son. Stop being lazy. You got apps that can teach you Spanish for free. You can learn French for free with your apps. And you playing video games. You getting beat. Transition from what you could get to what you could give. Now, I wasn't alive when Kennedy was alive, but that speech resonates with me.
And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country.
When you get to a place where you don't go for what you can get, but you go for what you can give, you're going to see your life change tremendously. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Your life is going. So when you come to work on the dude that is responsible, Mr. White, for Michael Jordan's brand, he told me, Eric Thomas, you know, listen to me very closely, son. It's not possible. It's past possible. He said, listen, you got to stop telling people you wrote a book, and you got to start saying you're an author. It's a different mindset. It's a different mindset. He said, if you say you wrote a book, that could be it. But if you say you're an author, it means you write books for a living. That's what you do. And you got about 4 or 5 more books in you, easy. It's a mindset. We changed the whole game. It's a mindset. You probably didn't even notice it, but I'm mic'd up right now. You probably didn't even know it. I'm mic'd up right now, different mindset. I used to speak back in the day and just see myself as a speaker. Now we own a company. E.T., I don't see nothing wrong with that. When you become successful, you don't ask what's wrong with something. You ask what's right with it. When you become successful, you don't ask what's wrong with something. You ask what's right with it. When you become successful, you don't ask what's wrong with something. You ask what's right with it.
And the worst thing in life is not to be broke. The worst thing in life is to taste some success and then you gotta go back to being nobody.
The first one, the last one. Jerry Rice was always the first one, the last one. I'm telling you, don't get from the sea thing. And I dare you for one time in your career, I dare you to exhaust yourself. I dare you to leave every single thing on the field, one season, everything, walk off exhausted. Like Mike when he got 45 with the flu. He had the flu. Like for real, let's be honest. One of your players got the flu and they tell you I got the flu, I can't play. You're like, cool, I understand. We'll catch you next game. Mike was like, I got this, don't worry about it. But Mike, you got the flu. My flu is still better than your normal game, all right? Whatever your little game is, my flu gonna outdo your game. So I'm gonna play. Some days when I run, man, I go 6-7, but when I finish, I'm not breathing hard. Raise your hand if you know what I'm talking about. I just finished doing 6 miles, but I'm not breathing hard. Raise your hand. You know exactly what I'm talking about. No, raise your hand if you've ever experienced it. You've done what you're supposed to do, but at the end of the day, you're not really breathing real hard. Raise your hand. Mm-hmm. You put the workout in. You did exactly what you're supposed to do. You did your exercise. You did your reps, but you still, you good. Tell me if you know a time when you ran so hard, you worked so hard, that you felt your chest. After you finished, you felt your heartbeat.
Get yourself together. You the man now, but you ain't gonna be the man forever. And the worst thing in life is not to be broke. The worst thing in life is to taste some success, and then you gotta go back to being nobody. That's hard.
Yeah. He showed up. He showed up and played. How many games? 2,000. He was considered one of the best in the game because he did what? Now, I'm here to tell you, if you show up to that many games, and that's the beautiful thing about this sport, you gotta grind. This ain't football, baby. Football, you get Sunday, I'll see you next Sunday. This is every single day, and sometimes they ask me to do two. All right, this is a whole other level. You gotta grind. He came every day and grind. Now watch me, when you come up on a regular basis and you playing, just you got a life. Stuff happened. I know some stuff happened with my man. Somebody in his family died. I'm sure him and his wife had some challenges. Son got sick, right? I'm sure it was a lot that happened in those 2,139 games. It was a young man who, you know, he wanted to make a lot of money, and so he went to this guru, right? And he told the guru, you know, I want to be on the same level you are. And so the guru said, if you want to be on the same level I'm on, I'll meet you tomorrow at the beach. So the young man got there at 4 a.m. He all ready to rock and roll, got on the suit, should have worn shorts. The old man grabs his hand, said, how bad do you want to be successful? He said, real bad. He said, walk on out in the water. So he walks out into the water, watch this. When he walks out into the water, it goes waist deep. So he like, this guy crazy.
That's the tip I got for
the- Hey, you look like I want to make money. You got me out here swimming. I didn't ask to be a lifeguard. I want to make money. He got me in. So he said, come on a little further. Walked out a little further. Then he had it right around this area. This shoulder area. So this old man crazy. He's making money, but he's crazy. He said, come on out a little further. Came out a little further. Right at his mouth. My man, like, I'm about to go back in here. This guy is mine. But the old man said, I thought you said you wanted to be successful. He said, I do. He said, walk a little further. He came, dropped his head in, held him down, holding him down. My man didn't scratch it, holding him down. He had him held down just before my man was about to pass out. He raised him up. He said, I got a question for you. He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. I don't know how many of y'all got asthma here today, but if you ever had an asthma attack before, you short of breath, SOB, shortness of breath, you wheezing. The only thing you trying to do is get some air. You don't care about no basketball game. You don't care what's on TV. You don't care about nobody calling you. You don't care about a party. The only thing you care about when you're trying to breathe is to get some fresh air. That's it. And when you get to the point where all you want to do is be successful as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. And I'm here to tell you, number one, that most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. You don't want it badder than you want a party. You don't want it as much as you want to be cool. Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep. Some of you love sleep more than you love success. And I'm here to tell you today, if you're going to be successful, you gotta be willing to give up sleep. You gotta be willing to work out for 3 hours of sleep, 2 hours. If you really want to be successful, some days you're gonna have to stay up 3 days in a row. Because if you go to sleep, you might miss the opportunity to be successful. That's how bad you gotta want it. You gotta go days without, listen to me, you gotta want to be successful so bad that you forget to eat. Beyonce said once she was on the set doing her thing, 3 days had gone by, she forgot she didn't eat. Because she was engaged. I'll never forget when 50 Cent was doing his movie, I did a little research on 50, and 50 said that when he wasn't doing the movie, he was doing the soundtrack. And they said, when do you sleep, 50? Sleep, he said, sleep. Sleep is for those people who are broke. I don't sleep. He said, I got an opportunity to make a dream become a reality. Don't cry to quit. You already in pain, you already hurt. Get a reward from it. Don't go to sleep until you succeed. Listen to me. I'm here to tell you today that you can come here, you can jump up, you can do flips, you can be excited when we give away money. But listen to me, you will never be successful until I don't have to give you a dime to do what you do. You won't be successful until you say, I don't need that money. Because I got it in here. When you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. I'm willing to grind every day. I'm willing to get up Saturday at 5 o'clock in the morning. I'm willing to get up on Sunday morning and drive to this university 4 hours when I just got flown first class to Vegas and stayed in a hotel for $2,500. I'm willing to stay in the Holiday Inn. Why? Because I'm willing to grind. I'm willing to take every engagement. I don't care if it's middle school, high school, college, Fortune 500, Fortune 10. You ain't gonna stop me because I got drive. Sleep is for those people who are broke. I don't sleep. Said I got an opportunity to make a dream become a reality. To be able at any moment to sacrifice what you are for what you will become. It's about heart. You come to a place where, you know, being smart ain't enough. You gotta have heart. Pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year. But eventually, it
will subside, and something else will take its place. If I quit, however, it will last forever. I understand the game. I know who I'm competing with, but I gotta try.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. Beyond measure.
I'm gonna show you how great I am. Last night I cut the light off in my bedroom, hit the switch, was in the bed before the room was dark. I'm gonna show you how great I am. Only last week I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean I make medicine sick. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
This kid's gonna be the best kid in the world. This kid's gonna be somebody better than anybody ever knew.
I'm gonna show you how great I am. I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. I'm gonna show you how great I am. All of you chumps are gonna bow when I whoop him. All of you, I know you got him. I know you got him picked, but the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am.
Somewhere along the line, you changed. You stopped being you. You let people stick a finger in your face and tell you you're no good. And when things got hard, you started looking for something to blame, like a big shadow. Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody. It's gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Because if you're willing to go through all the battling you gotta go through to get to where you wanna get, who's got the right to stop you? I mean, maybe some of you guys got something you never finished, something you really wanna do, something you never said to someone, something. And you're told no, even after you pay your dues. Who's got the right to tell you that? Who? Nobody. It's your right to listen to your gut. It ain't nobody's right to say no after you earn the right to be where you want to be and do what you want to do. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. Playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We're all meant to shine as children. It's not just in some of us, it's in everyone. As we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we are liberated from our own fear, our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure.
All of you chumps are gonna bow when I whoop him. All of you, I know you got him. I know you got him picked. But the man's in trouble. I'm gonna show you how great I am.